Hello, everybody. Greetings from Mumbai. Yes, butterflies, dragonflies, grasshoppers, and even snakes, they've fascinated me since childhood. In fact, I wanted to become a biologist, but being weak in maths, I didn't get admission in science, so I had to do political science. And I got a job in a big cosmetic company, good salary. Selling cosmetic was fun, but I realized something was missing. You know, the caterpillar within me was restless, you know, looking for his wings to fly for the place, the right place. And that's the time, actually, I worked as a volunteer with the Bombay Natural History Society, BNHS. And they offered me a job too. The salary was very meager, actually. You know, when I told my mom that I wanted to quit my job and go for this NGO, she was mad. She said, right from the four figures, you'll come to three figures. Nobody will marry you. But my father actually, you know, came to my rescue. He said, let him be happy first. Because if he's happy, he's satisfied in his job, he will grow. And he was right, actually. There, my father gave me wings and I was free like a butterfly. I landed in the BNHS there, the library, right, the library assistant. And I could, actually, library is a treasure house. I could learn, and I was like a thirsty animal, you know, lapping up everything. Because I was so much interested in wildlife, nature. And that's where I met people also. Even Dr. Salim Ali used to come there. He was a resident then, and I was just a newcomer. And one day I mustered up my courage, you know, to compliment that, sir, you have a beautiful handwriting. But what he said, I was really surprised that he said, my handwriting was really not that good. But I worked hard, actually, to cultivate, to acquire the style. Because he said, you want to show the world, show the best side of your work. And when you get an opportunity, give the best. And I got it. The BNHS was a place where actually I grew up, you know, and meeting people and reading their explorations. And I started fantasizing of going to different parts of India, seeing India. I had not seen India. And that's the time actually Bittu Saigal launched his Sanctuary magazine. And he wanted to do a story on butterflies. And I started working on butterflies on my potted plants right in the balcony. And when I saw that, how the female butterfly comes and touches each leaf, you know, actually she's tasting those leaves. Butterflies taste with her feet. And when she found the right leaf, she laid her egg very carefully. And next 3 days, the pale yellow egg turned into orange. And then the caterpillar walks in, biting its eggshell. That's his first meal. And then the caterpillar is literally eating machine. And what more important I found was, caterpillars actually hire bodyguards. Caterpillars can't defend themselves. But who are the bodyguards? The ants. But ants don't work free. So who's going to pay them? The caterpillar has got a special gland at the end of his abdomen. From that, they secrete a sweet liquid. And the ants lap it up and protect the caterpillar for his life. That's some of the interesting things I found while working on this butterfly life story. And the butterfly is just a glutton, you know, it's eating much, race against the time to grow before somebody gobbles it up. And then it comes to rest. And then it starts pupating. And within the pupa, a magic takes place, you know. All that organs of a creepy, crawly caterpillar dissolve and a new entity starts forming within just 2 weeks. And then we wait for the magical moment. And the flap opens of the pupa. And there you see the beautiful butterfly, a flying entity walking out. It's a magical moment. And this is the magical moment that hooked me up. And I was after them, chasing butterflies. It usually happens in the morning. And you don't know when, you just wait for it to happen. And there it was. The caterpillar turns into creepy crawling into beautiful flying entity. And this article, when I published, I was noticed. Even at BNHS, they noticed that you have a homegrown author here. Why don't you write a book on butterflies? I said, I do, but I don't want to sit in the library and, you know, check up with other people's references and copy rather what they have done. I wanted to actually see where they live, you find butterflies, actually photograph them. And then every family outing turned into butterfly outing, actually, for mine. So we were in Tabo, the last village at the Indo-Chinese border at 10,000 feet with my wife, my son, driver, We're looking for one kind of butterfly that flies about 10,000 feet. That's called Apollo. And there we are looking for this butterfly. I saw one butterfly flying. It was Apollo. I was ready with the camera. I jumped in. And it was flying very slowly, you know, steadily. I started following it up. I was sure to get it. I was about to close in when the butterfly suddenly changed its course and started flying uphill. And that I could not follow it because, you know, climbing uphill at 10,000 feet is just impossible at a rarefied atmosphere. I was huffing and puffing after that, but I could not. I saw that butterfly going far and far and lost it. And there I lost my first chance to photograph this most elusive butterfly I wanted for my book. I was very angry. I just came back stomping my feet. I fought with my wife. I scolded the driver for no reasons, and I lost it. So next year, again, I was in Valley of Flowers looking for this butterfly. After 2 days, I find the same butterfly, 10,000 feet Valley of Flowers, or blue aster flowers. This time, I decided to stalk it slowly. I walk like a chameleon. I stalk it 2 steps ahead and 1 step behind. 2 steps. You know, chameleon walks like this. If you rush at it like a lizard, it'll fly. But chameleon walks, it's an invisible walk. I was sure, and was about to focus on it, it took off. I thought it might sit on another flower, but no, it just sailed down the valley. There. I was helpless watching it. The next third attempt, I was in Ladakh. At 17,400 feet at Khardungla Pass. It's the highest motorable road in the world. And there I saw the Apollo. There it was, yes, on the road. I jumped out with the camera loaded, cocked. I started following it and praying that it should not go uphill or go in the valley. But, you know, at 17,500 feet high up there, with not properly acclimatized, your heart is thumping against the chest, your head is throbbing. I was visibly shaking, actually, and trying to follow the butterfly there. And finally, the butterfly sat down, and I closed in and got my first shot. Oh. And after that, I went in a clicking frenzy of 40, 30 shots. I got it, the Apollo that I chased it for the last 3 years. And the butterfly had not left me in my dreams for 3 years. I got it then. And finally, I got what I wanted. Actually, persistence plays, and you have to be slightly crazy about it to get it what you want. But the real treasure house, or real the hotspot for butterflies, because I was doing a book on butterflies of India, is the Northeast, actually. Sikkim, Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Nagaland, Mizoram, Meghalaya. 900 species of butterflies occur there, out of 1,300 species found in India. And that's like a paradise for butterflies. But going there is really tough because the forest of Assam are leech infested, bloodthirsty leeches, and invisible nasty mite that make you scratch for the next 6 months. And then you have angry elephants waiting at the corner. But being crazy for these butterflies actually made me overcome all these hurdles. And I faced and did what I wanted. I got my images. I finally wrote the book. It took me 10 years to cover the entire India. India is huge. This book became a bestseller for the BNHS. But during this chase, actually, I saw India. It is an amazing place, an amazing array of animals, birds, insects, people, culture. I realized that one lifetime is not just enough to see India. You have to know India, see India. It's, and I stopped going outside now because there's so much to see, so much to learn, so much to know about India. And that's where I met people also. And I met a lot of young people who wanted to become biologists. And that was, I found my mission, that to guide them, to encourage them. But I had lost my chance to become a biologist. I wanted to be happy. And their happiness was my happiness. And today it has become my mission to guide. And a lot of youngsters do come to me for the guidance. I know with butterflies, I learned one philosophy. Have you ever touched a butterfly? You must have found the color powder on your hand. The butterfly you touched gave you the shining colors, right? You can be a butterfly too. If you have a shine within you, give this shine to others to make others happy. And be a butterfly, as happy as butterfly. Thank you.